现在我们也来看看骑着驴橘子的耶稣基督，看他一生所成就的事。他未生的时候，天使对玛利亚说，这婴孩就是世人的救主，将人从罪恶黑暗救赎出来。他是上帝的平安来到人间，使人和神和睦，是以马内利，上帝与我们同在。他在12岁的时候就知道他来的目的与使命，就是以他的父的事为念，就是知道上帝的心意是要做拯救、医治、恢复的工作。他就是神的国来到人间，要占领夺取的是人的心，要救赎我们的灵魂体。他要释放我们从魔鬼的管辖和捆绑，要粉碎一切黑暗的势力及作为，破除一切的咒诅，要给一人今生有丰盛的生命，来世有永生的盼望。30岁的耶稣出来到各村各城传扬神的国，宣告平安福音的好消息，在短短3年的时间就完成了他的使命。当他被挂在十字架临死的时候，就说了一句话，成了。弟兄姐妹朋友，生命本来就是短暂的，是脆弱的，很多事情我们根本没办法掌控得了，也不知下一秒会有何事发生。其实在这疫情的期间，也让我们学习了好多宝贵的功课。圣经在雅各书4:14这样的说，你们的生命是什么呢？你们本来是过眼如烟，转瞬之间就消失了。144篇第4节，人不过像一口气，他的年日仿佛影子消失。在102篇第11节，我的年日好像日影偏斜，我也好像草一般枯干。所罗门在传道书也写着，一切都是空虚的空虚。耶稣也曾说过，人若赚了全世界，赔上自己的生命，有什么益处呢？现今这世代是以你的成功和失败，你能够贡献多少作为指标，看你的外表、你的实力，衡量你的成绩及果效。你虽然能够达到这一切，凯盛的一次顶峰的成就，但这一切都会成为过去。花会凋谢，人也会老，年轻的活力一天也会衰退，追梦追理想恐怕有时也会迷失自己。以金钱势力为保障的，以成功为指标的，往往会让我们失望，我们也没办法知足的，但也满足不了别人对我们的要求及期待，有时真的是身不由己。当时在场的民众和门徒都以为这次耶稣进城是要登上作王的，就是他们所期待的弥赛亚，连耶稣自己的兄弟也挑战他到耶路撒冷城去传教，证明自己一下，不只是在乡下做英雄，做 Jora Kampong。 如果你是耶稣的弟弟妹妹，你会如何的看待这位哥哥自称是弥赛亚、上帝的儿子、与神平等、行各式各样的神迹？圣经却有记载，他们如此说是因为他们不信的原因。这里呢，要和大家分享有关我小丑事工的生涯，目前都停顿了一阵，也不知道几何可以再一次的打扮作戏。这次的暂停 pause 看来有一段的日子， 走在这黑暗的隧道，还有一些漫长的路，也看不到前头的光。疫情之前，我都有曾经经历过凯盛，成就的一刻，有名和利，也都享受无尽好的待遇，一切都蛮顺利。在高峰时，心里也有自豪说，事工都很积极的发展，看来一定会持续，没有尽头，天下无敌。也对自己说，一切都是理所当然的。过去的十几年都东奔西跑，都在数算一年几次出国服侍，到了几个国家，有时候也会和同行同路的做比较，也常听人说这是独一无二的扣子叔叔 Uncle Button， 好嗨的感觉。所累积多年的经验可以很顺其自然的带过，不用看稿的，多次都会靠自己，有今天的成绩该是多年所付出的努力。但2020年3月份从美国回来之后，也是我最后一次到国外服侍，到今天还是门关闭户的，跨不了国，跨不了州，跨不了省，甚至在 MCO 的期间都出不了门。感谢上帝的爱、恩典与怜悯，保守供应我一家在这个疫情的期间却没有缺乏。最感恩的就是让我有这个机会能够调整不是态度的方向盘，纠正我眼目的焦点，对成就、成绩、成功与失败另眼相看。上帝的话也提醒我，不要自气高大，不要自以为聪明。这个时候让我们来看最后一个影片，有关于成功人生与意义人生的不同之处。
When I was at the University of Florida, for every home game, we would get in the bus at our hotel and we would drive right by the stadium and we would stop at what's called the Gator Walk. And every game I played there, there was probably 20 to 40,000 fans at this Gator Walk ready to greet us as we get off the bus. I would see all these people. I gotta tell you, there were a lot of voices that started to hit me. One of the first voices that instantly hit me was pride and arrogance, because I would look out and I would see thousands of jerseys with my number on it. I would look out and I would see Bible verses that they were wearing because I wore them. And so for a second you thought, dang, I'm something. They're here for me. This is pretty cool. I must be somebody. There's a picture that I stumbled across, and it's one of Time's 100 most influential images of all time. And it's the picture of this young girl. She's on her way from her village to a feeding center not far away. And she's so malnourished and she's moving so slow that this vulture is waiting to attack. So the young man that took this picture, I think there was probably something in his heart that he wanted to do good, he wasn't sure. So he captured this picture and he just waited, and then the vulture got closer. So he kind of shooed the vulture off and then he walked away and the vulture would come right back. And he was told, because of some of the sicknesses in the areas, don't touch anybody, don't do anything. And so he didn't. He didn't. He did nothing. Because apparently the cost was too much. So he left. He went back. The New York Times published this photo in 1993. In 94, he won the Pulitzer Prize for this photo. 4 months after this, he chose to end his life. You see, every single one of us, we have a chance to be successful in life. And you know what? I hope you are. I really do. I hope you're successful. There's nothing wrong with being successful. But success is just about you. But significance is about other people. You see, that man that took that picture, he had success. That's one of the greatest honors a photographer could ever have. But obviously it wasn't enough. It wasn't enough. So what's going to be enough for you? You see, success is great. You can do a lot of things with it, but it's not going to be fulfilling. And you can never forget that sense of urgency that it's not about your timeline, it's about their timeline. While you might have 30, 40, 50 years, they have days, minutes, moments. She had moments, but it wasn't worth it to go pick her up. It wasn't worth it to give her a hug. It wasn't worth it to tell her about the gospel. Yeah, I won a Pulitzer Prize, but what does it matter? What does it matter? It doesn't. And I think the greatest tragedy in life is we're going to look back one day and say, I was successful in things that don't matter. I want you to be successful, but more than anything, I want you to be significant. And when you live for Jesus and you love people, I believe you're going to have a life of significance.
耶稣终于来到了耶路撒冷城，众人都喊着，何塞啊，何塞啊，高高在上的何塞啊，但他不是来占领的，而是降服上帝的旨意。他们所等待的弥赛亚，就是逾越节的羔羊，牺牲在十字架，让你我能与神和好，得着平安，借着他能到天父上帝那里，得永生和将来的指望。弟兄姐妹朋友，当你晓得活在这世上短短几年的意义和使命的时候，就是活出凯盛的生命， Living a triumphant life, not measured by success, but the significance. 不是那一刻的凯旋进程受尊重、赞美、高举、得奖赏、欢呼而已，乃是能成为祝福的管道，改造他人的生命，成为神喝用的管子。盼望今早听信息的都能够活出凯盛的生命，荣神益人。愿上帝赐福大家。